What I'm doing is demonstrating how to make a drum. What I first did is I soaked the alkyd right here, and I also soaked the elk lacing, what we're going to use to string up the drum, and these will make the heads of the drum. The drum that we have is a 26 inches round by 12. This is be considered as a big drum. That's how big it is. Then it's made out of plywood. Then this right here, for the out to cover it, some people will paint it, tape it, but today I used a fleece blanket to give it a more Native American design look. And so first what we're gonna do is, this is one hive. What we're gonna do is measure this drum that will fit this. So, do is you measure, put your drum down. Then the next step is, since this is 12 inches, I normally go 3 inches around overlap and 3 inches at the bottom overlap. Because you don't want it to cut it too close because it can tear. So I already pre-marked this. So this is my 3 inches right here. I usually take my ruler and I go 3 inches from my marking. And that'll be right here. I'll cut it out. This is your drum head. You'll never get a full circle. So what I do is now is what I always do, I always make sure that it's gonna fit. What I want it to do. It has that 3-inch overhang. This is one I pre-cut out already. I'll show you guys. It's the same Please leave it the same. Fold your height half. Now this is the fun part. When you fold your height in a half and half, you'll go from the edge. I'll usually do an inch and a half up because you don't want it too close to the edge. If you put it too close to the edge, you can tear your height. So I'll do an inch and a half up, but then you do 2 inches. So my mark will be right here. That's one hole. Then every hole you're gonna do 4 inches of from each other. But always make sure your holes are 1.5 inches from the edge. Use a hole puncher to hit all the marks that you just put on. Sometimes you might have to do it twice. Depends on how thick the height is. Now you take it apart and you have all your holes. So you go back and you're gonna re-poke them to make sure everything went through. And you have to add an extra hole right beside of it, just so the lacing could go through. Sometimes your hole puncher likes to act up on you. Next time I usually get a pen or something and I make sure these. Second.